organizing committee. Once again, thank you for the invitation and accept my congratulations for such a perfectly organized symposium. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm not an endocrinologist, but mainly involved in osteoarticular diseases by quite natural way. I'm interested in involved in symptoms and diagnostic difficulties made by hyperthyroidism. From yesterday's and today's splendid lectures, we know a lot about osteoarticular disorders of endocrine origin. Hypogonadism, hypercortisism, hyperthyroidism, and mainly primary hyperparathyroidism is responsible for 20 to 30% of all cases of osteopenia and osteoporosis. And also frequently are seen myopathy and joint and soft tissue involvement. We know the mechanism of secretion and synthesis and secretion of parathyroid hormone, but the main important is very important is level of calcium. Even very slow decrease in the level of calcium is a very strong stimulator of parathyroid hormone. Usually the Thank you, I'm very sorry for it. Usually, normal food condition, the low level of calcium, the high level of parathormone. But what happened in the case of parathyroidism? In the same time, the high level of calcium and high level of parathyroid hormone. So what happened in tissue when simultaneously high level of parathyroid hormone and calcium acts on soft tissue? Normal calcemia is required for normal neuromuscular function. The regulation of level of calcium is possible due to promoting bone resorption and release calcium from skeletal reservoir, inducing renal reservoir of calcium and excretion of phosphate, and indirectly enhancing intestinal calcium absorption by increasing the renal production of active vitamin D. Elevated ionized calcium as well as elevated vitamin D inhibits secretion of parathyroid hormone, whereas serum phosphatase increases parathyroid Se Krishna. Hypercalcemia is resulting from excessive secretion of parathyroid hormone from one or more of the four parathyroid glands. Is in 80% due to benign adenoma of one of the parathyroid hormone. Primary hyperthyroidism occurs in all ages, but is most frequent in the sixth decade of life. Classical PTH is associated with skeleton, from skeleton, osteopenia, osteoporosis, osteitis, fibrosa cystica, bone cysts, and brown tumors of long bone. From the side of kidney, hypercalciuria, nephrolithiasis, and nephrocalcinosis. Among others, myopathy, a sense of weakness, peptic ulcer, pancreatitis, vascular calcification, and arthropathy. From other clinical factors leading to hyperthyroidism, we can list chronic hypocalcemia, elicit an increase in the size and number of parathyroid cells. Vitamin D deficiency is linked to excessive production of PTH, as well as hyperphosphatemia, as seen in renal fracture, is associated with parathyroid hyperplasia and hyperparathyroidism. In response to hyperphosphatasia, fibrous growth factor 23 is secreted by osteoclasts and acts on the kidney to inhibit renal phosphate absorption. So, what is going on in the soft tissue when simultaneously observe high the level of parathyroid hormone and calcium. PTH did not interfere with proliferation, but inhibited chondrogenic differentiation and chondroprogenitor cells. PTH also decreased human cartilage in vitro, regeneration and decrease DNA and glucosaminoglycans content, influencing some quality of cartilage. The first and most often seen symptom is chondrocalcinosis. In association with aging, normally occurs in association with aging, osteoarthritis, hypomagnesemia, hemochromatosis, hypophosphatasia, hypercalcemia, and hyperparathyroidism. It's detected in 31% of patients with hyperparathyroidism and is increasing with age. Age is very important in this phenomenon because, as we see, at the age of 50, it occurs in more than 4%. In 60s, more than 15%. And over 70s, 37%. In comparison to control, is only 2.8%. Next characteristic feature of hyperparathyroidism is sacroiliitis. The characteristic feature is subchondral bone resorption with erosive changes with bilateral sacroiliar joint widening. In MRI, we see bone marrow edema in 60% and enthesis. Next one is a pseudo god. Normally we see two forms on pseudo god. One is pseudo god symptom seen as intermittent attack on arthritis associated with endocarcinosis has been suggested to be the diagnostic clue of hyperparathyroidism. Or another form is a complication after parathyroidectomy that relieves hypercalcemia on or after the second day after surgery in one or more joints, often involving the knee joint. What about the neuromuscular involvement in PHPT? In patients with PHPT, generalized weakness and easy fatigability were common. 52% reported paresthesias and muscle cramps. 29% loss of pain sensation or loss of vibratory sensation with diminished reflexes. The muscular weakness seen in PHPT was not caused by neuromuscular transmission. No typical myopathy was observed, but in 44% death with bone pain and proximal myopathy, half of them experienced death bone fracture in some Indian studies. What about the muscles function? 72% of PHPT patients were symptomatic and 28 of them were asymptomatic. Patients with symptoms compared with not PHPT matched control experience, significantly lower quality of life, lower well-being, impaired postural stability, reduced isometric muscle strength, decreased physical performance. Asymptomatic patient showed significantly lower muscle strength at knee, extension and flexion, and impaired postural stability than in matched controls. Take it all together. Musculoskeletal manifestation of PHPT in a rheumatology practice. The Popo and co-workers describe back pain in 15%, more than 15%, generalized bone pain about 10%, rib and cage pain 8%, pseudo-clubbing 4%, and from articular manifestation, chondrocalcinosis 17%, more than 17%, arthralgias 15%, non-specific synovitis 10%, and muscle weakness 8%, and myalgia 5%. What is the message of this elaboration? Impaired muscle function may contribute to increased fracture risk independent of bone mineral density. As some musculoskeletal symptoms observed in PHPT patients can be quite unusual and may represent diagnostic dilemmas for the practicing rheumatologists, endocrinologists, orthopedists, and neurologists. The message of this elaboration is title of the Borgia work, Hyperparathyroidism, a Forgotten Cause of Musculoskeletal Pain. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you.